Hello students, how are you? I hope you are all safe at home, right? Okay, the last session we had discussed about the chapter measurements. In that, what we had seen? We had seen what is measurements and where we are using measurements in our real life situations and what is length and how, what are the steps to be followed while taking measurements. So these are all the concepts we had seen in the last session. In this session, we are going to discuss about the what is volume. And we have to find the volume for solid, liquids and gases, and that is differentiate between mass and weight. So these two concepts are we are going to discuss in this session. Okay. So before we are going to discuss about what is volume, first we have to know that what is length and what is breadth and what is height. So what is length? We already discussed in the last session. What is length? Length is the distance between one end and the other desired end. That is the distance between one end and the other desired end. Length is the fundamental quantity. What is meant by length? Length is the fundamental quantity. What is my fundamental? Fundamental is nothing but the basic quantity. Okay. So with the help of length, we can find the volume or area. So volume is a derived quantity. What is volume? Volume is a derived quantity, and area is also derived quantity. Why we are saying that area and volume is a derived quantity? Since because we are calculating the volume and area with the help of length, breadth and height. So these three are fundamental quantity, and these two, area and volume, are derived quantity. Okay. So what is length? Length is the distance between one end and the other end. And the unit of length, SI unit of length is meter. Okay. And what is breadth? Breadth is the distance or measurement from one side to other side. Okay. Breadth is the measurement from one side to other side. And it is also measured in terms of meter. And what is the height? Height is the measurement from top to bottom or from bottom to top. So it is also measured in terms of meter. Okay. So we need length, breadth and height to find volume. So it is a fundamental or basic quantity. Okay. So before we are going to find volume, that is discuss about volume, we need to discuss about area. What is area? Area is a measurement of a substance or measurement of an object or measurement of a circular path or any path. So that is an area. For example, consider your home. In your home, there will be many places, that is kitchen, dining room, hall, bedroom. So first we have to find the length, that is area of a dining room. What we will do? We need to know the length and breadth. So to find an area, we need to find length and breadth, that is measurement of an object or measurement of a path. Okay, measurement of a space. So that is length into breadth. We have to multiply length and breadth to find an area. So it has length, that is area, has a unit centimeter square or square centimeter. How it will come? Since because length also measured in centimeter and breadth also measured in centimeter. So by multiplying this, we can get centimeter square. Okay. So we are getting the unit of area is centimeter square, or we can write it as square centimeter. Okay. So consider here a box, that is square box. For square, all sides are equal. That is all sides are equal for square. So here, the length of this box is 10 cm and breadth of this box is 10 cm and height of this box is 10 cm. So to find an area, we need length and breadth only. So we have to multiply length and breadth to find an area. What is length? 10 cm and breadth 10 cm. By multiplying this, what we will get? You will get 10 into 10, 100 cm. Unit square, centimeter square is the unit. Okay. So how will you find area? By multiplying length and breadth. For example, consider a solid object to find an area. Here we can choose the box as a solid object, and we have to find the area for this object. So to find an area, what we need? We need length and breadth. So what is length? Length is the distance between one end and the other desired end. And this one is breadth. That is from side to side. Measurement from side to side. So to find the length, what we need? We need a meter scale or centimeter scale. So we have to find the length with the help of this scale. So for a see here, the steps to be followed, already we discussed, no? The zero to be coincide on the object. So the zero is coincide here, and see here, what is the length of the object? That is 10.5. okay, right? So the length of the object is 10.5, and we have to find the breadth. So the zero to be coincide on this object, and see what is the breadth. I think the breadth is 8, right? Okay, so 8 centimeter. So we have to multiply here length into breadth to find an area. What is the area here? I think 84 centimeter square. So what is the unit? Centimeter square is a unit, and the if you multiply the length into breadth, we get 84 centimeter square. So the area of this object is 84 centimeter square. Okay, so next one, we have to find the volume. So what is volume first? Volume is the amount of space occupied by an object. So amount of space that an object occupies is the volume. So to find volume, what we need? We need length, breadth and height. Okay, so consider the same solid object. Already we find length and breadth. Now we have to find the height of this solid object with the help of the scale. Okay, see here. What is the height? I think 4 centimeter, right? So to find volume, what we need? We need length, breadth and height. Length is 10.5 and breadth 8 and height 4. If you multiply this, what you will get? You will get 336 centimeter cube. So for finding the volume, we need length, breadth and height. Since why we need length, breadth and height? Because volume is the space occupied by an object. So we need length, breadth and height. Okay, for area we need only length and breadth, since it is a measurement of an object. So here it is, since it is a volume, we need length, breadth and height. So for how we can find the volume for this cubical box, we can find by multiplying length, breadth and height. That is 10 into 10 into 10, and if you multiply, what we'll get? 1000 centimeter cube. Since the unit of volume is centimeter cube or cubic centimeter, we can find the volume and we can write the unit as centimeter cube. So this is the method for finding area and volume. So here we can discuss the volume for solid. Okay, so we can find the volume of solid with the help of length, breadth and height. Okay, have you clear about this? Next we are going to discuss about volume of liquid. Next we have to find the volume of liquid. How will you find the volume of liquid? We can find the volume of liquid with the help of the container, since liquid occupies the shape of the container. And solid, we need to find volume with the help of length, breadth and height. With the help of length and breadth and height, we can find the volume of solid. But here for liquid, we need a container, since the liquid occupies the shape of the container. Okay, so see here, it is a beaker. So see here, it is a beaker. It has a markings, that is 50, 100, 150 and 200. With the help of this, we can find the volume of the liquid. And see here, it's a conical flask. Okay, it also has a markings, that is 100 ml, 150 ml, 200 ml and 250 ml. With the help of this, we can find the volume of the liquid. And it is a pipette. Okay, so it is, see here, it is a 20 ml pipette. Okay, with the help here, you are having marking. Okay, with the help of this, we can find the volume of the liquid. These are used in chemical lab. Okay, conical flask, pipette, burette are used in chemical labs for taking the chemicals. Okay, we also used for, I think so, in your home, milkman use a beaker to find the milk, how much milk we are added, that and all we can, that is poured by pouring the milk into that container, that is the beaker, we can find the ml of milk, we can find the volume of milk. So with the help of this container we can find the volume of the liquid. So finding the volume of liquid is quite easier than finding the volume of solid. Okay, so what are all the items used for finding the volume of liquid? That is graduated cylinder, beaker, pipette and burette. Okay, so the what is the unit of liquid? That is, it is measured in terms of liters. Okay, it is measured in terms of liters. Here we are using milliliter. Since it is a lower quantity, we are using milliliter. Okay, for higher quantity, that is higher volume, we can use liters to measure. Okay, so next, measuring the volume of an irregular shaped object. How will you measure the volume of an irregular shaped object? There is no mathematical formula to find the measuring of, that is volume of irregular shaped object. So then how will you find? We can find with the help of the container. Okay, so see here, in your textbook they have given one example. Okay, that is volume of stone equal to volume of water displaced. That by adding the stone into the water, we can find the volume of solid object, that is volume of irregular shaped object. Okay, by adding the, that is by immersing the stone into the water, we can find the volume of an irregular shaped object. Okay, so see here, they have given an example. Initially they had taken the water level 50 ml and by after immersing the stone into the water, the water level rises to 75 ml. So how will you find the volume? By subtracting the water, that is rising water level, with initial water level, we can find the volume of the stone. Okay, so we can consider, then here we can say, had an example, we have taken an example. See here, it is a beaker, we are adding the water to 150 ml. So the initial water level here they had taken 50 ml, we have taken 150 ml. Okay, so we consider this stone as an irregular shaped object. We have to find the volume of this irregular shaped object. How will you find? By immersing the stone into the water. So see here, we had immersed the stone into the water. So the water level rises to here 150 and it is here 200. So the water level is between 150 and 200 and it is here. So we can take an, we can consider this as 180 ml. Okay, so the water level rises to 180 ml. So how will you find the volume of this irregular shaped object, that is stone? See here, for initial water level is 150 and the water level rises to 180 ml. So by subtracting 180 with 150, we can get 30 ml. So the volume of the irregular shaped object is 30. Why here we are using ml? Since the object is, we should not mention here ml. Why? Because solid object should be measured in the, by the unit cubic centimeter. So we have to convert this ml into cubic centimeter. So the volume of a solid object is 30 centimeter cube. Okay, here 1 ml equal to 1 cubic centimeter. So 30 ml equal to 30 centimeter cube. Okay, so the volume of an irregular shaped object is 30 centimeter cube. So by using this method we can find the volume of an irregular shaped object. So next one, we have to find the volume of gas. How will you find the volume of gas? So volume of gas, that is gas, it will expand and it also compress. Gas will also expand and it also compress. When you add a gas into the container or any object, what will happen? It will get expand. The gas will expand. And the same gas, when you add that, for example, consider cylinder. When you add gases into the cylinder, what happens? It compress. So gas also expand and it also compress. When we add the same gas into the smaller container, what it will happen? It will compress. For example, consider balloon. If you add that is air into the balloon and if you press, what will happen? It compress. And it also, when you add gas, what happen? It expand. So gas expand and it also compress. And volume of gas cannot be find easier. So it is not easier to find volume of gas, but and it also measured in terms of liters and also in meter cube. Okay, and 1 meter cube equal to 1 kiloliter, or 1 centimeter cube equal to 1 milliliter. So volume of gas is measured is not quite easier, but we can find with the help of the container. Okay. So the next concept we are going to discuss is mass and weight. What is mass? Mass is the amount of, that is the amount of matter in an object. Mass is the amount of matter in an object. And what is weight? It is a gravitational pull experienced by the mass. We are saying the unit for weight kilogram. That's wrong. The unit of mass only kilogram. The unit of weight is Newton. So for example, consider a beam balance. So we are having beam balance is an example for mass, for taking mass. So how will you find the measurement for an object? By keeping the known weight one side and unknown weight another side. By keeping the known weight one side and unknown weight another side. For example, 50 kg in grocery shop, for example in market, they are using beam balance, right? They are using for 50 kilogram, 50 milligram for measuring the kilogram, for 1 kg, 2 kg. For measuring the kilogram, we are using the beam balance. By keeping the unknown weight one side and by placing the unknown weight one side. By using that, we can measure the measuring the unknown object measurement. Okay, so that is an example for mass. For example, weight, how will you take weight? With the help of electronic balance. So that day I had shown you an example for electronic balance, right? So by hanging the object in that electronic balance, we can find the weight. Okay, so that is the weight is the gravitational pull experienced on the mass. Weight is the gravitational pull experienced by the mass. But mass, it is a normal weight, amount of matter contained in an object. So mass and weight differ from each other. Mass is measured in kilogram and weight it is measured in Newton. So in your example, they had given an for example, see here, it is a beam balance, okay, and it is an electronic balance, okay. So this is an beam balance. We can measure, that is unknown weight here and unknown weight here. With the help of this, we can measure the weight, that is mass of an object. And with the help of this electronic balance, we can measure the weight of an object. And it is beam balance, that is electronic balance, will be used in jewelry shop, grocery, for taking the weight of grocery items, and medical shops, and markets, they are using the beam balance, that is electronic balance. Okay, so the next one, clock. Have you seen a clock? How will you measure time? Days changes into night, night changes into day, and seasons also change. So How will you measure time? We can measure time with the help of clock. So everyone is bearing clock, that is watch in your hand. And in your home, everyone is having clock. The clock may be in different ways. That is, in your home, everyone in your home, you will have watch in your home. That is clock in your home. The structure of the clock may be varies. That is analog clock, digital clock. So the structure may vary. But for what we are using clock? To measure only time. So for example, consider running race. You can have running race with your friend. What will you say? You can say 1, 2, 3. How will you say that 1, 2, 3? That is rough time. That is, you can say the rough time. 1 little second, 2 little second, 3 little second. Okay. And how will you find that is, you are having seconds, minutes and hours. So the unit for time is second. Already we discussed in the last session, the SI unit of time is seconds. So how many seconds? There are 60 seconds to make 1 minute. 60 seconds to make 1 minute. And 60 minutes make 1 hour. 60 minutes make 1 hour. So how many seconds to make an hour? 60 into 60, that is equal to 3600 seconds to make an hour. So 60 seconds make 1 minute and 60 minutes make 1 hour. Okay. How to say the time and how to watch the time? If not, you can learn with the help of your parents. Okay. From now, you can know how to learn the time, how to know, how to learn how to see the watch. Okay. So far we have discussed what we have discussed. That is volume. What is volume? The amount of space occupied by an object is volume. So how will you find the volume of a solid object? With the help of length, breadth and height. And then volume of liquid. How will you find the volume of liquid? With the help of the container, by pouring the liquid into the container, we can find the volume of the liquid. So here we are using graduated cylinder, beaker, pipette and burette to find the volume of the liquid. Next one, measuring the volume of an irregular shaped object. How will you find? There is no mathematical formula. We can find the volume of an irregular shaped object by immersing the irregular shaped object into the container, that is liquid, adding the liquid and by immersing the irregular shaped object into the container, we can find the volume of an irregular shaped object. Next, how will you find the volume of gas? Gas will expand and it also compress. The unit of gas is cubic meter, that is meter cube or liters, or we can also measure it in liters. Okay. Next one, differentiate between mass and weight. Mass is the amount of matter contained in an object and it is measured in terms of gram. And what is weight? It is a gravitational pull experienced by the mass and it is measured in Newton. The mass and weight differ from each other. You should not confuse with mass and weight. Okay. So mass will be measured with the help of beam balance and this weight will be measured in terms of with the help of electronic balance. Next one, clock. How will you measure time? How will you find time? We can measure time with the help of clock. So there are number of types of clocks. What are they? Analog clock, digital clock and sand clock. This sand clock is used in olden days. So 60 seconds make 1 minute and 60 minutes make 1 hour. Okay. So there is an assignment for you. So see here, there are 4 questions. We have to do these 4 questions. Okay. So next we can wind up this session by watching a video. Thank you, students.
In this video, we will be going over the volume of a rectangular solid. We will begin by reviewing the area formula. We will explain derived units. We will define rectangular solid. Then we will go over 3 units of volume in the metric system and 3 units of volume in the United States system. Let's begin by reviewing the area formula for a rectangle. And we're going to explain derived units. Derived units are what you have when you take two or more units and combine them together to have a new unit. Here we have area, which is length times width, or it could be length times length. So with area, we have one length, which gives us units squared. Now we have a different shape. And see, this shape right here has the side, which we can use the area formula, but it has an extra width over here, or extra length. So we have to change our formula and move from area to volume because we're adding an extra length. Now let's define this shape. This is a rectangular solid. A rectangular solid is a box-shaped object. It has six flat faces, and all the angles are right angles. This rectangular solid is also known as a cube and a rectangular prism. So again, our volume formula is length times width times height. And the area formula uses units squared because they're just two lengths, and the volume has three lengths, so it's going to be units cubed, or units to the third power. Now let's put in an example. Let's have our length be 15. Let's have our width be 5. Let's have our height be 10. We plug all those into our formula. 15 times 5 times 10 gives us 750. And that will be 750 units cubed. If we were in United States system, it'd be 750 yards cubed, or feet cubed, or inches cubed. Now let's try another example, yet with fractions this time. We're going to let the length be 7 over 8. We're going to let the width be 2 over 8. And we're going to let the height be 5 over 8. So now we multiply those across, and we have 70 over 512. And that's units cubed. Now in the metric system, that's going to be 70 over 512 meters cubed, or centimeters cubed, and last, it may be millimeters cubed. That's the end of our video. Take care and thanks.
Quantitative measure of how much space an object contains. Objects are placed into three general categories: liquids, regular solids, and irregular solids. Water is an example of liquid. Liquids are measured using a graduated cylinder. The standard unit for liquid volume is the liter. An example of a regular solid is a brick. The volume of a regular solid is calculated based on the measured length, width, and height. The standard unit for the volume of a regular solid is cubic meters. A rock is an example of an irregular solid. The volume of an irregular solid is determined by measuring how much liquid it displaces. It is recorded in cubic meters or liters. Let us look more closely at each means of measuring volume.
Let's accept it. Most of us think that mass and weight are pretty much the same thing. Are they? No, they're not. There's a very simple way to understand the difference. Mass is simply the amount of matter that's present in the object. Now consider two situations. One in which an object is on the Earth, and second in which the same object is on the Moon. Will the mass of the object be different in these cases? To answer this question, we ask ourselves another simple question. Will the amount of matter present in the object be different in these cases? Absolutely not. The matter in the object is not changing at all, which is why the mass will be the same in each of the cases. The mass of an object remains constant no matter where it is placed. The standard metric unit of mass is the kilogram. Another concept we'd learnt about an object's mass was that it is a measure of its inertia. Greater the mass of an object, greater will be its inertia. Inertia is nothing but the tendency of an object to resist change in its state of motion. So now we have an idea about what mass is. But what's weight then? How do we understand the weight of an object? Mass is nothing but the measure of how much matter an object has. Weight is a measure of how strongly gravity pulls on that matter. It's the measurement of the gravitational pull of an object. Let's understand this using a simple example. Say there are two places, place A and place B, and there's an object of mass m. In place A, the pull of gravity is x units. And in place B, the pull of gravity is 2x units. Clearly, the pull of gravity is stronger at place B. Now understand this well. The mass of the object will be m at both the places. But the weight of the object will be greater at place B because the pull of gravity is stronger. As the gravity is twice as bigger, the weight of the object will be twice as much at place B as compared to place A. So the weight of an object is a measurement of gravitational force acting on it. How can we understand weight using a formula? We know the Newton's second law of motion, which says that the force acting on an object is the product of its mass and acceleration. When it's acceleration due to gravity, we can replace A with a lowercase g. This force due to gravity is nothing but the weight of the object. So if we consider the weight of an object to be uppercase W, we can rewrite this equation as W equals m times g. So the weight of an object is the product of its mass and acceleration due to gravity. What will be the SI unit of weight? Can you guess? It'll be the same as that of force, Newton. As the value of g at a particular place is constant, we can also say that the weight of the object is directly proportional to its mass. Here's the main takeaway from this video. The mass of an object remains constant everywhere, whereas its weight depends on the gravitational force at the location.